by suggestion at least referred to as AP in one of the handwritten notes prepared by middleman Guido Haschke. Now, the Congress has been questioning the authenticity of this note. Even another middleman, Christian Michel, has been questioning the authenticity of the note that you see on your screen. But in perhaps the most important revelation by the Italian High Court judge who delivered the verdict, well, the judge told me earlier that he believed this note to be authentic. Take a look. Now, Judge, I have this handwritten note in front of me. It has the initials AP. It has other coded references. You've said you've taken note of this handwritten paper prepared by Guido Haschke. Would it be fair to say on the basis of this that you believe the money went beyond the Tyagi brothers to Indian officials and politicians?
Well, first explication and explanation. The object of judgment was the role and the behavior of the two Italian men accused and was defined by the indictment. So that was for the court the object of the judgment, the principal story, to verify the validity of the indictment. We had to verify also the surrounding of this story, and the surrounding of the story give traces of the other presences of activity of other people, other bureau who should be could have supported Augusta in the deal. But this is a surrounding, this is something that came around the state, around the principal story, and so we didn't enter in the middle of this second part of the story.
Right. So you're saying that there are there are traces of the presence of other people who could have supported the entire process, but you did not think it was your jurisdiction to investigate the Indian angle. But what's important is, Judge, you're saying that you have not given a clean chit to anybody, and you are also saying that the money could have well gone beyond the Tyagi brothers to the politicians based on this note of Guido Haschke, because when you say traces of other people, I assume that's what you mean.
The handwritten paper by Mr. Haschke gives traces of which we took note of it, and we said maybe that someone other has supported Augusta. The investigators said that Paul is an indication, an initial stage for a politician. AP is an initial of an important politician, Indian politician. And in correspondence of the this initial, there are indicated numbers who could be, should be, the amount that would be paid. But was not interest of the court to say if these facts was real or not, if this fact was founded, because these facts were not in the indictment. And so we have only a scenery surrounding, and we say in the judgment that is reasonable, is possible, that someone other has been has received money for this deal, but that's all for us.
All right, brief excerpt from that very, very important interview from the Italy judge. That full interview at 8:30 tonight after our discussion. Abhishek Singhvi is on the program with us. He led the defense for the Congress today. Prakash Javrekar, the union minister, who was also in the house throughout that debate, is also with us. Senior journalist Avleen Singh and Vinod Sharma are with us as well. In that interview, and you'll be hearing a lot more of it in that in this program, the judge clearly described AP to be an important political person in India. He also said that they took note of and they took cognizance of this handwritten note by middleman Guido Haske, and they presume that the money columns in it does suggest traces of political support, political kickback, and in his exact words, money could have been or should have been paid to the names that have been suggested in that note. In fact, later, as you'll hear in the interview, the judge also says, I have given a clean chit to absolutely nobody, and it's for India now to probe who of its own politicians are involved, to what extent. Let me start with Abhishek Singhvi. Abhishek Singhvi, you quoted the judge from another interview today in your defense of the Congress. The judge, as you have heard and will hear, is actually saying that this handwritten note he believes to be authentic, and he believes AP to be an important political person in India, and he believes it's very possible, based on the evidence he got, that there were political kickbacks. Does this not puncture the Congress defense?
On the contrary, what you are now saying, which is not really part of the official domain of the debate, proves exactly the opposite. And this, you know, this might sound technical, but you hear it very carefully, Parkha. One, it is the judgment which I quoted from, where two places, I'm now talking only of AP,
yes,
because you're talking only of AP.
Yes.
The first page quotes Michel saying, I don't know who this person is. The second page quotes Vinere, a prosecutor or a lawyer, who says, I'll jog your memory because he looked up in the internet and AP stands for Ahmed Patel. Mm. So the two pages I cited from the judgment, point number one. Point number two, the judge in the interview to NewsX has two separate paragraphs, one clearly on Ahmed Patel, where he says, I'm not reading again Sonia Gandhi's paragraph, where he says it three times, we have no direct evidence. The focus of the investigation is not him. We have nothing to ask him questions for. This is in quotes.
But his interview to us suggests a convenient interpretation of a clean chit.
Barkha, obviously he's not giving a clean chit.
Exactly.
Ahmed Patel, Tyagi brothers are not accused before him. How
exactly
can he give a clean chit or a
exactly
black chit?
So why are you quoting him
accused
to make your case?
Nobody's saying that. No, we are quoting him in rebuttal to the BJP. The BJP is quoting chapter and verse from the judge. We are not saying it's a clean chit. On the contrary, our point is that 24 months you could not get a single piece of document, evidence, conviction, charge sheet, 164 statement by the CBI, by the ED. We are saying we'll be happy if we are convicted or acquitted by the CBI ED. It is the BJP for the last 1 week, Barkha.
Okay,
it's going all over the world saying
the
judgment has come. And third, last point.
Okay.
What he told you was what he believes, making it clear in the same interview with you, that's not what he has said. He believes that it could well be a path for inquiry, but he has neither held so in the judgment. Plus he has said that we were not concerned with Ahmed Patel. We picked up with him, it may well be. That's his belief.
Okay.
Beyond the judgment.
Can I just briefly
These
say,
four
Abhishek,
points are important.
Abhishek, I want to get the minister in, but I want to briefly say to you that the judge says it was not in the domain of his judgment to deal with the Indian politicians because he was dealing
exactly
with the Italians. He was dealing with his own citizens.
Then why is the BJP...
But Abhishek Singhvi, he is pointing to the handwritten note that you have not spoken about, prepared by Guido Haske, which talks about political kickbacks, and he says he believes that note to be genuine.
Which he believes, what he believes is irrelevant because that note has found no approbation in the judgment. He's telling you in an interview, but he kept it out of the judgment because legally he found it unsustainable.
Okay, let me get Prakash Javrekar.
What he's saying is, you look into it in India, just consider 24 months,
yeah,
and today is the same. The only difference is the judgment. So the last 1 week, all the allegations by the BJP are based on the Italian judgment. It's exactly what we are saying, based on the Indian judgment.
You're making a legal
Italian
point. You're making a legal point, Abhishek. You're being the lawyer. But Prakash Javrekar,
factual.
Okay.
No, no. Everything is based
let me
on
get
the
Mr. Javedkar
judgment.
To speak now, Abhishek. You made your
judgment.
Point. Mr. Javedkar, here's the point. Abhishek Singhvi, he's being the lawyer politician. He's making a legal argument, and he's correct in saying that the Italian judge was not concerned with the Indian politicians. They happened to fall, in a sense, this evidence fell into their lap, and the judge is giving his own assessment. But the Congress does raise one challenge to the BJP. Can you prove? Can you substantiate your allegations, or can you take this beyond political rhetoric? Because clearly for the BJP, the target, the finger of suspicion is pointing now at the Gandhis. This is no longer a story about SP Tyagi, Mr. Javedkar. So can you back this up with legal evidence is the question from the Congress. There's the political narrative, but there's also the legal question.
Yeah, but let me tell you, I must congratulate you and compliment you for the good interview you have done with the judge, and when he says that he authenticates and it's a genuine note of Haske which enlists all the payoffs, and he also says further that AP is an important Indian politician. Yeah. This is very important. He only says further that because Indian bribe takers was not his, that was not put on trial in Italy, it can't be.
Exactly.
And therefore, he has not said, but he has actually said everything.
Yeah.
Now in India, you take it from me that guilties will come to the fore. Today, Congress stands badly exposed. He is a brave lawyer, but a defeated Congress has actually no grounds to say anything on this. I just put one more point.
Yes.
And you rightly said, can only Tyagi have done this?
Yeah.
Answer is absolutely no. Because what was done? The cabin height was changed to 180 meters.
Yeah.
Altitude was brought down to 4,500 meters. So compromises to have only one vendor instead of six who were interested. Second, field trial was allowed outside and not on the helicopter which was purchased.
Yeah.
The purchased three helicopters found incompetent and did not perform in actual trials when we use them here. Then benchmark price increased sixfold from 739 crore to 4,800 crore.
Yes.
And most interestingly, the RFQ was entered with Augusta Wasteland, Italy. And the whole contract was done with AIWL, which is an international arm, with RFQ was not done. And the number of aircraft helicopters was increased from 8 to 12. All this cannot be done by Tyagi.
Okay.
It was political decision.
So Prakash Javedkar, you are saying that Tyagi was not
and
empowered.
His mentioning of Indian leader.
Now, Prakash Javedkar, you are saying that the judge does not name Indian politicians in his conclusion because that was not his domain. But in his authenticating the handwritten note of Guido Haske in that interview to us, he has effectively confirmed political kickbacks. Is that what you're saying, Mr. Javedkar? Because that would be
absolutely.
My conclusion. That would
and
be my conclusion.
And now Congress says defenseless.
Abhishek Singhvi, I'll allow you to come in before Tavleen and Vinod come in. The fact is you're arguing this legally. Would you accept that at the moment this is what it looks like to the people of India, of a certain generation who still remember Bofors, that this looks like Bofors 2.0. This looks like the Gandhi's Bofors moment of 2016. You had a defense deal that cost Rajiv Gandhi an election. You now have a political narrative where the Aam Aadmi and Aurat is going to look at this and say the aid of Rahul Gandhi and the aid of Sonia Gandhi are both at the center of this scam, and with Guido Haske's handwritten note being authenticated by the judge, this spells political trouble. It may or may not spell legal trouble, Abhishek, but it definitely spells perceptional political trouble.
Don't think that the common man and woman eat grass. Don't think that the common man and women are gullible and foolish. Please give them the respect they deserve. They have a far greater native intelligence than most of us. I don't think anybody believes that, and this is very important, Barkha, that what happened in 2014 and today, there is no difference, not a speck of difference, except an Italian judgment. Now, if the BJP has not raised it, is it not commonsensical to assume that the only reason they are raising it now is the judgment?
Okay.
In the same breath, you say that the judgment doesn't deal with these accused, doesn't indict them, doesn't have jurisdiction over them, and yet the BJP's entire assault is based on parts of the judgment, because before that everything was quiet. But look, now when I go to the judgment to rebut the BJP, you turn round. No, when I go to the judgment to rebut the BJP, which I did by reference to the judgment, yes, you turn around and say that yes, the judge excluded this from the judgment. The judge did not find it legally tenable evidence.
No, he did not think
but
it was.
But the judge in an interview has said that I believe.
He believes that money took
the money trail went beyond Tyagi.
He said that to me in clear words.
Of course, it is written in the judgment. It may have gone to Tyagi, it may have gone to Joint Secretary Air Defense. There are 10 positions given there.
Okay, I want
where
to hear
is
Sabine
the suggestion
Vinoda.
That it went Sabine to Vinoda. AP Sabine. Or CP?
Okay,
that's the point. That is what we read in the judgment today.
Okay. Requesting Mr. Javedkar and Mr. Singhvi to hold on. Tavleen, how do you see these developments?
To me, who remembers Bofors very well, it's really Bofors redux. So what you have is a situation where somebody very close to the royal family of the Congress Party is implicated, and in the last case it was Quattrocchi and his wife, where Bofors bribe money was actually found in their accounts. And it's very bad luck for us that the Vajpayee government did not investigate. So what I'm hoping really is that this time they investigate quickly every little detail about this case so that we stop having this happen anymore. Had they done it with Bofors, you would not have had the kind of bribes that have been paid in this case. And bribes have been paid. They couldn't have been paid to an Air Force officer.
Or not only to an Air Force officer. Vinod.
Not just to an Air Force officer.
First of all, I think that there is similarity with Bofors.
Yeah.
But there is one crucial difference.
Which is?
Bofors issue made the entire opposition resign on the eve of, the parliament's tenure was coming.
Yeah.
And the entire opposition was one against the Congress.
Yeah.
I would base much of my comments today on what I saw in the House. You know, I haven't spoken to the judge. And Mr. Javedkar and Mr. Singhvi have primarily repeated what they've said, what was stated by the two sides in the House. But the takeaway from me, from the House debate was, that the majority of members wanted a probe monitored by the Supreme Court.
Right.
And that is the only answer to this logjam.
Right.
Because both sides are going to give a narrative which suits them. Majid Memon of the NCP, who is a lawyer himself, said on the floor of the House that the court verdict from Italy is the information for India. Because the court doesn't have...
That's exactly what the judge told
precisely.
Me. He said this is where India now must begin
precisely.
Its own
court. That's what he said. And I think it made a lot of sense to me that this is information should be treated as information by the Indian investigating agencies.
So you're saying this judgment is the starting point?
This judgment...
And not a conclusion?
No, it is not. It cannot be a conclusion because it does not deal legally...
Specifically.
...with the questions that you are asking. And at the end of the day, it has to be a case tenable in a court of law.
Let me just get Tavleen in on that quickly. Tavleen, do you believe that is, you know, the Congress would say the BJP had 2 years. Why didn't it probe all this? Why did it take another judgment? All this information has actually been in the public domain for years.
Well, that's a failure on their part. But from what I have gathered from today's debate, it was deliberately delayed in the last 2 years of the last government, and that they've just started to do this. And obviously the fact that there is this judgment now gives them a chance that they didn't have before. Because it was a long drawn out process, they probably ignored it, but this judgment really gives them a chance to look further.
Okay, Prakash Javedkar, why was it that we saw the BJP leaders being much more circumspect in the House, not really naming the Gandhis, when every single leader outside the House has effectively made this about Sonia and Rahul Gandhi? Kirit Sumaya even raising questions about how Rahul Gandhi's aide Kanishk Singh is linked to a firm, MRMGF, whose head was questioned by the Enforcement Directorate today. Rahul Gandhi's aide saying, well, I'm estranged from this part of the family. The fact is that this is clearly about the Gandhis as far as the government is concerned, yet you didn't take their name inside the House. Why was that?
No, first let me respond briefly to what our friend Vinod Sharma has said.
Yes.
SC monitored inquiry. It's curious that is when the UPA appoints CBI inquiry, That too on my question. Because today Anthony said it in the House that Javadekar asked that, and therefore we said both CBI and so that he referred to. So that time nobody raised the point of SC monitoring. So when Congress is in power, it's only CBI.
Mr. Javadekar, this when was, this point was made by other opposition parties. Court. This was demanded by Mayawati, by Mr. Ramgopal, Mr. Ramgopal Yadav, Mr. Majid Naiman, one after another.
And Congress
of
also.
Other opposition parties.
No, of course, and yes, Congress. Also.
Yes, Congress
Gulam
also.
Nabi and Anand Sharma.
Yes, yes, correct.
And therefore, how can there be a double standard? When Congress is ruling, it can be only CBI inquiry. Hmm. And when BJP is ruling, it has to be.
But what is your
Supreme
problem
Court
with the Supreme Court?
This is absolutely.
But Prakash Jadhav, what the media is asking, why? What's your problem with the Supreme Court monitor CBI probe?
We have absolutely.
It would give
no
it more credibility.
With Supreme
exactly.
Court as such. The issue is when we are all agencies are already in advanced stage, and now they are after money trail. Why? At this stage, when there is no case of any malafide investigation going on,
yeah.
It is not an investigation like CWG or 2G, where Supreme Court has to take over.
But why would you resist the Supreme Court taking over? I'm a bit confused. You believe this is a gigantic scam. Why would you not want the Supreme Court to monitor it?
No. Because we are capable of doing it, and CBI is investigating independently and in the right
time. Mr. Javadekar,
there is no malafide. See, we are, well, I'll tell you, we are not the law minister who dictates the CBI probe report to the court.
Okay, Abhishek Singhvi.
That time it was necessary.
Yes.
Now it is not.
Abhishek Singhvi.
Barkha.
Yes, yes, Abhishek.
I am not ready, is what BJP says for the JPC. I am not really happy with the CBI because you started it, and I am not prepared for a Supreme Court inquiry. Then what do you want? I'll tell you the answer. What you want is to keep the pot boiling without any conclusion. A conclusion means a proper inquiry, a trial or a conviction or an acquittal or a quashing of charges. Hmm. These are all finite, certain, predictable, time-bound results.
Okay.